Good morning. You're welcome to another time of MFC 365. This is a beautiful day. It's a day the Lord has made, and we are praying. Hallelujah. It's a wonderful privilege to come into God's presence to be able to pray by the help of the Holy Spirit. Today is day 205, and our prayer focus is I will praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I will praise you. Amen. We are starting off as usual with thanksgiving. It is good to give thanks to God, and we are thanking God for all that God is, all He has ever been to us. Even the things we don't know, God has been awesome, He has been marvelous, and the best thing to just do is to give Him thanks. The Bible says in Psalm 63 and verse 3, it says, because your loving kindness is better than life, my lips will praise you. Let us go ahead, let us begin to offer to God the fruit of our lips, which is thanksgiving. Let us begin to bless His holy name. Let's begin to adore Him. Let's begin to bless Him. Let's begin to acknowledge who He is.
Shut up,
this next segment, we are praying for our nation and we are praying for our church, our local assembly. Bible says in the book of Psalm 63 verse 2 and 3 in the Living Bible translation, it says, how I wish I could go into your sanctuary to see your strength and glory, for your love and kindness are better to me than life itself. How I praise you. Let's go ahead and still begin to give God all the glory. Let's give him praise for our local assembly. Let's appreciate God over this nation, Nigeria, that Nigeria is still not broken, that our country is still standing. Go
Oh,
glory to God in this segment. Hallelujah. We are praying for our pastors, our mentors, and our parents. Hallelujah. Let's lift them up before God in prayers. Bible says in Psalm 63 verse 7, for you have been my help, and in the shadow of your wings I will sing. Hallelujah. Let's go ahead and begin to bless the name of the Lord. Let's begin to give him all of the thanks. Let's begin to sing his praise. Let's begin to worship him on behalf of our parents, our pastors, and our mentor. Let's lift up a melody unto the Lord for preservation of life. Oh, Marudosi Kaya Baba, for defeating the enemy on their behalf, for mercy. And segment, we are praying for our families, and we're praying for the family unit. The Bible says in Psalm 63 verse 7, That is because you are the one who helps me. It makes me happy to be under your protection. Glory to God. We are beginning to pray and say and declare that because it is God that helps us, because we have found the help of God, because the help of God has found us, God has made us happy. And that is why we are happy to be under God's protection. Go ahead, begin to speak it to yourself, begin to declare it to yourself. In the name of segment. We are praying for our finances. We are lifting up our financial life before God. Bible says in Psalm 63 and verse 5, it says, "You satisfy me more than the richest feast. I will praise you with songs of joy. You satisfy me with the riches of feast. I will praise you with the songs of joy. Let's begin to magnify the name of the Lord. Our Bible says that God satisfies us with the riches of feast. Let's begin to imagine the goodness of God towards us concerning our finances. In the segment, we are praying and we are making warfare unto the Lord. The Bible says in Psalm 63 verse 7, in the Message translation, it says, because you have always stood for me, I am free to run and play. We will begin to say, because the mighty God, because the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords has stood by us, because the Lord stands by us to fight our enemies for us. That is why we can stand and mourn and play. That will be our portion in the name of Jesus. Nothing will hinder us in the name of Jesus. In this segment, we are praying the desires for the month. The Bible says in Psalm 63 and verse 5 in the New Living Bible, it says, "At last I shall be fully satisfied. I will praise you with great joy." I will praise you with great joy. Let us go ahead right now and begin to praise God with great joy, because the Lord has satisfied us. The Lord will satisfy all of our desires. The longing of our hearts shall be fully satisfied by God, because God our Father is a double-breasted one. He is the one that hears and listens to our In this segment, we are praying Psalm 91. Psalm 91 is our covenant security scripture, and it is just good for us to confess it and speak it into our day. The Bible says in Psalm 91 and verse 7, it says, 1,000 people may fall dead at our side, or 10,000 right beside you, but nothing bad will happen to you. Hallelujah. That is a promise from God that nothing, no harm shall happen to us. No harm shall happen to us emotionally, physically, spiritually. No harm shall happen to our children wherever they are. They are covered. Go ahead, begin to prophesy. Segment, we are praying and we are pleading the blood of Jesus. We are going to put the blood of Jesus in our mouth and begin to sprinkle it all over every issue, every situation, everything that pertains takes to our life with faith in our heart. Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 26 and verse 28, the wine is my blood, which will be poured out to forgive the sins of many and begin a new agreement from God to his people. Go ahead right now, begin to plead the blood of Jesus upon you for the remission of whatever sin you might have committed. And
I'm not going to be able to do that.
praying the Pauline prayers. The Pauline prayers are the prayers that Paul prayed for the early churches, and they are powerful prayers that we can pray in the now. Bible says in the book of Philippians chapter 1 and verse 9 in the Living Translation, it says, my prayer for you is that you will overflow more and more with love for others, and at the same time keep on growing in spiritual knowledge and insight. Open your mouth and begin to pray in the mighty name of Jesus. I am growing in knowledge. I am growing in spiritual insight in the name of Jesus. The eyes of my understanding is enlightened in the name of segment, we are praying for mercy and favor. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, favor and mercy are two strategic things we can pray for to advance our lives. Bible says in Psalm 63 verse 3, because of mercy, because your mercy is better than life, my lips will give you praise. That scripture is saying the mercy of God is better than life itself. That means if I have the mercy of God, I have more than what life can offer. Begin to go ahead. Go ahead right now and begin to plead the blood of Jesus. Begin to plead the mercy of God. Begin to declare it. We are praying for healing. Oh, Marusotaya Baba, let faith rise up on our inside. We are praying and we are trusting and believing God for bodily healing, emotional healing, healing for the brokenhearted, healing for those who are hurt, and of course healing from every sickness and diseases. Bible says in the book of Psalm 91 verse 10, so nothing bad will happen to you, no disease will come near your house, no disease will come near your home. Begin to declare that over you, over your family, over your house, over your loved ones. Begin to declare it, no disease will come near my home. Amen. We have come to the end of today's prayers. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we give you glory. We give you praise. Oh, let's lift up our hands, let's lift up our hearts and begin to bless the name of the Lord who has helped us. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, thank you, thank you. This is the confidence we have that when we pray according to your will, you hear us. Thank you, because if you hear us, our petitions are granted and we are grateful. Hallelujah. Thanks for joining me today. God bless you. God will go forth ahead of you into today. Your today is blessed in the name of Jesus. Your today is glorious in Jesus' mighty name. Join me same time tomorrow in Jesus' name. God bless you.